the Spirit probably means become more absorbent with you. That's what it means. Submit more to the Holy Spirit. You can put a sponge into water, but if that sponge is all clogged up, it's going to take time for that water to absorb into the sponge. Or if it's dirty, you've got to get rid of that old stuff so that there's more room for the water to come into the sponge. And that's exactly what it's like. It's a question of yielding to the Holy Spirit. A yielded vessel is a vessel that can be filled with the Holy Spirit, saturated. It means you continue to dwell in the Holy Spirit and you continue to serve in the Holy Spirit. Now, as I say, this image of the cup makes people think more about the Holy Spirit being in us rather than the New Testament way of thinking that we are in Him. That's a better way of looking at it. It means living in His presence. And there is a big distinction between the two. Those who talk about empty cups being filled only think like that are suggesting that they are big enough to contain the Holy Spirit. I'm going to tell you, you're not big enough to contain the Holy Spirit. You need to be saturated with the Holy Spirit. It's like being plunged into the middle of the ocean. I don't mean on the top of the water. I mean, halfway, right there in the middle of the ocean, submerged with miles of ocean above you and miles of ocean on either side of you, miles of ocean beneath you. Hallelujah. Wonderful. So, the other thing is, when you think about this in individual terms, we're missing out on the blessing. It's the church that is filled with the Holy Spirit. God has put His Spirit upon the body of Christ. And we need to understand that we need together to be filled with the Holy Spirit for the task that He's given to us. That's the first description of being baptized